Hey guys, Dave from Nerdarchy, for nerds, by nerds, hanging out with.
I'm Ted.
And today we're going to talk about what does your class say about you, and we're going to be discussing the Bard.
If you want to get weekly gaming tips or learn how to game with Nerdarchy, scroll down below, click the link for the Nerdarchy, the newsletter, and you're all set.
So, what does your class say about you is our series where we discuss the different classes and, you know, what that decision entails for creating the character and the story and the role-playing aspects of the game. So we've talked extensively about mechanics throughout our Nerdarchy career. So, what kind of person becomes a bard?
Well, so many people have like a minimized view of what the bard is. And I think of the classes, the bard is one of those that is so wide open in personality and everything else that it can be hard to define. So typically, the bard is the jack of all trades who has gotten exposure to a lot of different things, or just by sheer coincidence, happens to be better than the average person at a lot of different stuff. But with this edition, they've taken away that jack of all trades, master of none, and actually put in the master of some.
Master of some and really good at everything else.
So you've got so many different flavors that you can go with Bard. And you're going to be able to pick basically anything you want and say, you know what, I'm really good at that.
So the thing about the bard, and one thing is very consistent, is their ability to interact with others and have others either do better or do worse depending on what they do. So right off the bat, no matter what kind of bard you are, you're a bit of a showman. You're a show person, should I say? That part you can't really get around. Like, you know, you're some kind of entertainer. Whether you're a scald type with the College of Valor, or you're giving lectures like a professor, but no matter what, you're still you still seek to entertain others. So I think that says that you're more than likely the person that is a bard is not going to be introverted. They're going to be an extrovert. They're going to like being part of the limelight. They want to be in the spotlight. They want people to, hey, look at me.
They're going to be charismatic, and they tend to either pick up friends really easily, and enemies just the same.
Yeah. So like if you're a bard and you go into the tavern, and you're like, I want to sit in the corner with my back to the wall so I can see the door. You're playing the bard wrong. That's definitely a different kind of bar.
You're gonna walk in the bar, and typically you're gonna get that cheers, Norm. People know who you are. It's just,
or you want them to if they don't.
Yes. It's like, wait a second, they don't know me here. It's time to smile.
Yeah. They might just break into an impromptu performance, and start entertaining, and hopefully they earn a couple coins while they're at it. But even within that, you could still play, a lot of different types of entertainers. You can kind of do the sad comedian, or you could do the ladies man, or I guess.
Well, I mean, you've got all the different.
I was going to go opposite of ladies man, but I don't actually know how you put that. I think they do. I think in our society it's very derogatory.
So you've got right or wrong. You can go with any kind of musical instrument. You can go crazy and do like the one man band type of situation, which is utterly hysterical. And
Polka will never die. Butters is actually a bard.
you can go with any of like the illusions and magic. You can go with juggling or any kind of physical interaction. You can go with just clowning around. You can go with essentially like a stand-up comedian, and literally jibe the people around you. And you can go like the combat showman who does essentially weapon tricks and weapon flourishes, and you know, they might be presented as more skilled than they are, or less skilled than they are, depending upon what they're trying to do. And do it that way. I mean, how many of you have sat there and watched, either video or in person, someone do a whip demonstration? It's really cool. Well, you know what? That's a bard.
Well, yeah, absolutely. Recently, they did an Unearthed Arcana where they revisited kits from AD&D, and they did two different types of bards. They gave you the jester, and they gave you the blade.
Right.
Which, you know, that when you talked about the whips and someone performing with weapons, that's it. Sword swallowers, you know, they're all blades, you know, they're not necessarily like it's, and it's interesting in a sense that you're still a showman, but it's almost like the darker aspect of being a bard.
Right.
Again, too, and the other thing is bards in Dungeons and Dragons are presented as either being a part of a college, a university, basically a larger organization, or at the same time you could just be an apprentice to another bard who is more skilled than you, depending on how you operate in your game. And again, like these will also dictate different things with the personality. Like if you're a bard from a college, you might be all about like that alumni. It'd be like you're pushing your college. You're like, you should go there. This is where the smart people go. It becomes an aspect of your character almost that you can see in modern society, and you can reflect that about how people feel about their schools, and you could kind of bring that into the game if you wanted to, or you could be like a hero worship of, you know, the guy you were apprentice under, or you know that might be a big thing, or maybe you have almost like a friendly rivalry with that person where you want to be like bigger and better than the person who taught you, like, you know, you want to have that to be your legacy. Or there's also tons of tropes where like the student turns against the master and vice versa, for different reasons, and not all of that which has to be nefarious.
Right.
But again, these are just different things that are going to reflect on how your bard might be different than somebody else's.
So to kind of, you know, wrap things up, bards are going to be experts. They're going to be really skilled at something. And I really feel that the expertise mechanic that several classes get is really powerful. And the higher level you get, the bigger that bonus becomes.
It should kind of like reflect your specialty as a bard in entertainment. You know, I in my opinion, anyway, you can do it however you want to do it, obviously.
You can either have it be that, you know, it's part of the reflection of your entertainment, or it could be, you know, pertaining to your areas of study that you do apart from your entertaining. But it should be linked to your college, in my opinion.
Well, it should be linked to your college. But see, I feel like if it doesn't, like, at the core of the bard, he's an entertainer. Like, that's what the class does. It's like where some classes aren't really professions, mm-hmm. This one is. Like you're it can be defined in different ways, mm-hmm. But your profession is you're an entertainer if you're playing a bard. Now, a lot of times, like we say, like a rogue doesn't really necessarily mean you have to be a thief. You just have a certain skill set that the rogue class lends itself to. Mm-hmm. A sorcerer, you're just born with that power. The warlock, you made a pact. With the bard, you went to school to learn something, you know, or you sought someone out to learn something specifically. And in my opinion, if that's something that you learn to do as entertainment is different from your expertise, it becomes a little weird.
Okay. Because
it's really easy for players to be like, yeah, stealth and perception, right? You know, sleight of hand, yeah, I'll give you that one because you can use that to perform.
Right.
But, you know, stealth and perception, I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to know it as a DM. I just think it's a gamist decision and choice that doesn't reflect on the role-playing aspects of that class. Like, I really think it should be, you know, acrobatics. Maybe not athletics, but acrobatics for sure.
Okay.
You know, the different knowledge skills are excellent. Like I said, sleight of hand can work really well as well.
Absolutely.
And that's off the top of my head without looking at
the
list.
And then, of course, you could take any of the musical instruments or anything that would be your performing tools.
Yeah, well, yeah, absolutely. And, you know, or persuasion. I feel that's totally justified, or deception, because again, those can be used in a performance as well. Right. Dude, you could totally do the bard where you like John Edwards it, and like, yeah, you know, and you're just running the I speak with dead con, and it would be so much easier, you know, in the fantasy setting as well.
Right.
Just because there's people that actually do it, for one. Two, you do have a little bit of magical talent.
Right.
And three, people are less informed, you know, so it'd be so easy to pull off.
Right.
I might have to do that bard. You know, in a previous video I said I was thinking about doing a blade singer, but now I might be thinking about doing that instead. I'm not sure.
Well, that's when you get into the hobby, you've always got a long laundry list of characters that you want to play that, sadly, they don't all get to be seen.
Yeah. I don't know how to pull that off in game, but it would be hilarious, I think.
I agree.
So I guess with that, like Ted was about to wrap it up, and let us know in the comments below what you guys think. You know, how do you define your bards? What are their personalities like? If you play multiple bards, how do you define one from the other? You know, or do they all kind of look like clones? While you're at it, like, share, and subscribe.
You can head over to nerdarchy.com and check out the forum. There's plenty of interaction going on there.
So until next time,
stay nerdy. So many people have like a minimized view of what the bard is, and I think of the classes, the bard is one of those that is so wide open in personality and everything else that it can be hard to define. So typically the bard is the jack of all trades who has gotten exposure to a lot of different things, and you're all set.
So, what does your class say about you? Is our series where we discuss the different classes and, you know, what that decision entails for creating the character and the story and the role playing aspects of the game. So we've talked extensively about mechanics throughout our Nerdarchy career. So, what kind of person becomes a bard?
Well,
hey guys, Dave from Nerdarchy, for nerds, by nerds, hanging out with.
I'm Ted.
And today we're going to talk about what does your class say about you, and we're going to be discussing the bard.
If you want to get weekly gaming tips or learn how to game with Nerdarchy, scroll down below, click the link for the Nerdarchy the newsletter, and say, you know what, I'm really good at that.
So the thing about the bard, and one thing is very consistent, is their ability to interact with others and have others either do better or do worse depending mm-hmm. on what they do. So right off the bat, no matter what kind of bard you are, you're a bit of a showman. You're a show person, should I say?
Mm-hmm.
That part you can't really get around. Like, you know, you
or just by sheer coincidence happens to be better than the average person at a lot of different stuff. But with this edition, they've taken away that jack of all trades, master of none, and actually put in the master of some.
Master of some, and really good at everything else.
So you've got so many different flavors that you can go with bard, and you're going to be able to pick basically anything you want.